Somebody say praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. His name is worthy to be praised. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is our miracle moment.
Amen.
Where we come into the presence of the Lord. We have come into his gates with thanksgiving.
Yes.
And into his courts with praise.
Amen.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together.
Amen.
The Bible says in Psalm 91, one of my favorite passages of scripture. Some of us can recite it from memory. But tonight we just want to consider that psalm. And claim these merits upon our lives. The Bible says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High God, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee. Would somebody say amen? Neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion, and the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet, because thou hast set his love upon me. Therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me. Would somebody say amen? That's what we came here to do. The Bible says, he shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. Oh, we don't serve a remote control God. He's not leading us from afar off. He said, I will be with you in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life shall I satisfy him and show him my salvation. I want to claim the merits of this psalm that is potent with promises upon our lives, that God will cover us with his wings, that he will bless us, that he'll be our shield, that he will bear us up in his hand lest we dash our foot against the stone. We want to claim protection over your families. The Bible says 1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but the plague, the pestilence, that weapon of the enemy will not prosper. It will not come nigh your dwelling. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked, but you will know that God is protecting you. He is on your side. He is present tonight, and he wants to heal. He wants to protect. He wants to save. He wants to bless. I don't know where you stand, but if you stand in the presence of Jesus, your circumstances can be transformed. We claim the merits of this text upon your life. Would you just leave wherever you are and draw to the altar as we get ready for this special moment of prayer? You are my... No, our prayer song is... Creating me. Amen? Let's sing that. Yes. come, come tonight. Come.
Create in me a clean heart and purify me. Purify me.
Prayer. Oh Lord, do an inside job. You can work upon my heart. Cast me not away.
Cast me not away from thy presence. Please don't take your spirit from me. Spirit from me. Restore the joy of salvation.
Jesus. Amen. And he's there to touch our lives. Shall we pray together tonight? Oh Lord, we come in your presence tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Claiming your promises upon our lives.
Yes, Father.
Oh Father, you have said in your word, you know the thoughts that you think towards us.
Yes, Lord.
Thoughts of peace and not evil.
Yes.
Thoughts to give us a hope and a future.
Yes.
Embedded in this promise, O Father, is a dwelling place.
Yes.
A place we can dwell in the midst of this life of challenges,
yes,
uncertainties, sickness, woe, violence, stress. O Father, you have said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yes,
oh, Father, you have given us a place of sweet release.
Oh, yes,
a place where there is peace above the storm.
Yes.
A place, oh, Father, where we can find sanctuary.
Yes.
And, oh, Father, that is in your name.
Yes.
For you have said the name of the Lord is a strong tower.
Yes.
The righteous can run into and be saved.
Yes.
And so, Father, we pray, O God, that you will cover your people with your feathers.
Yes.
May they trust, O Father, under your wings.
Yes.
May they abide in safety.
Yes,
O God, I don't know what challenges confront them on a daily basis, but you can be their rock, O God.
Yes,
you can be their tower of strength.
Yes,
you can be their battle axe when they cannot defend themselves.
Yes,
you are the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Yes,
you are Michael who stands up for your people.
Yes,
everything we need, you are.
Yes,
and so,
Lord.
Father, even at this time, we pray,
yes,
that you will stand up for your people.
Oh, yes,
you have said in your word, 1,000 will fall at thy side,
yes,
10,000 at thy right hand,
yes,
but the plague will not come nigh our dwelling. Oh, Father, so we pray that you will build a hedge around your people,
yes,
and about their house and all that they have on every side.
Yes,
may the enemy not be able to infiltrate or penetrate, oh God.
Yes,
if
Lord.
The enemy has already invaded the privacy of their homes,
yes,
to cause sorrow, pain, disagreement and strife and quarreling and fighting and sorrow, we bind the devil in the name of Jesus, and we command him to go. Oh Father, expel him from homes, expel him from marriages. But, oh Father, don't leave them alone. We pray that the sweet presence and the essence of the Holy Spirit will be experienced in every life and in every home.
Yes,
oh Father, you have said that you transform us with the renewing of our minds.
Yes,
oh Father, sometimes it's not the circumstances around us that needs to change. Sometimes it's our mentality that needs to change.
Yes.
Oh, Father, wherever we go, we will go with that problem, if we are the problem.
Yes,
and so,
Lord.
Father, we pray that you will create clean hearts and work a miracle inside your people.
Yes,
may conversion be experienced.
Oh, yes.
May they meet with Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray for the cleansing power of your blood.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Father, to take away strongholds and bad habits and the burden, the yoke of sin, oh Father, that your people have been living as slaves to. We pray, oh Father, that you will cover them with your blood and make them clean without and within.
Yes.
We pray, oh God, that they will stand faultless before the majesty on high.
Yes.
Oh Father, we pray for cleansing tonight.
Yes, Lord.
We pray for cleansing.
Yes.
That you will clean your people and make them whole.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Father, we pray for restoration tonight.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Some have wasted precious years.
Yes, Jesus.
Some have broken relationships that seem that beyond repair.
Yes.
Oh, God, they have done so much to create the difficult situation that they feel that there is no hope.
Yes.
But you are the repairer of the breach, oh, God.
Thank
You are the restorer of paths to dwell in.
Thank
oh, Father, you can restore the years that the locust and the cankerworm has eaten, oh, Father.
Yes,
you can restore. You don't have to bring them 5-10 years backward. You can, oh, Father, place them where they need to be in 2017.
Yes.
Oh, Father, some persons, their lives are broken.
Yes.
Their reputation is in a mess.
Yes.
Oh, Father, because of things that they have done.
Yes.
But you can restore.
Oh, yes, Lord. Thank you,
you can
Lord.
Restore broken relationships.
Yes, Jesus.
It's our lover's night, oh, Father, and there are many persons who are married who are strangers.
Yes.
They are many married, lonely people.
Yes.
Oh, Father, we pray that you will bring that essence of love into their lives.
Yes.
You will enrich them.
Yes.
You will bless them, oh, God.
Yes.
We pray, Heavenly Father, that you would mend relationships.
Yes, Lord.
Among
yes,
couples.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
But, oh, Father, among families.
Yes.
We pray for restoration.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Oh, God, we know that you are able to intervene. Bring broken situations back together
yes,
again.
Jesus. Yes, Jesus.
So I don't know, Father, the sorrow that your people feel, but you know it.
Yes. Yes, Jesus.
You know how difficult the circumstance is.
Yes.
Father, we pray that you would minister unto them.
Yes.
And they will be able to trace your divine hand.
Oh, yes, Lord.
And have a testimony in the future.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Father, this is the day you have made. We want to rejoice and be glad in every day that
yes,
you make.
Lord.
Oh, Father, we pray that you will turn our mourning into dancing,
yes.
our sorrow into joy.
Yes.
And, Father,
yes.
may we have a life that is satisfying, knowing that every day with you is sweeter than the day before.
Amen.
We thank
amen.
You in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let God's people say,
amen.
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 We worship you.
Somebody say amen tonight. If you're happy and you know it, say amen. If you really want to show it, say hallelujah. If God has been good to you, say I'm experiencing the transformation. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. God has been good. Would somebody say amen? This man up here is enjoying himself. Would somebody say amen? You see how he's moving his legs when he have the shak shak? You saw that? That's the joy of the Lord. Would somebody say amen? God bless you. God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, who say we don't have fun in Jesus? Amen? Ladies and gentlemen, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen? And so when we come, we rejoice and we are glad in the presence of our living God. Ladies and can I see all the visiting friends tonight? All our visiting friends, just give me a wave. You're on all corners of the tent. I see you out there. You are our guests. You got an invitation. You came. Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. Just give me a wave. Give me a wave. Amen. Now I see a few, but there is room for, we have room for many more. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our second week, and we are in the middle of the second week. There is much work to be done. Are you listening to me out here? Ladies and gentlemen, do you know that next week is our final week? You want to cry? You have to make hay while the sun shines. Next week is our final week of Metamorphosis. Are we together? So we need to do whatever we're doing, we have to do it now. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, God is calling us to do our part. Are we together? Let me see how many people from Patna here tonight. Just wave your hand. You from Patna and you here. Just wave your hands. Put your hands together for our Patna people. Would somebody say amen? Let me see how many people here from Dago Martin tonight. Just wave. Dago Martin people. Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. Let me see people from Pity Valley tonight. Pity Valley. Amen. Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a good clash come tomorrow night. Are we together? We're starting the clash tomorrow night. Amen. It is clash of the communities. Would somebody say amen? Now, I want to give the community that comes with the most visitors something special. Would somebody say amen? Is that all right? Is that all right? Let me see how many visitors coming from Patna. Visitors from Patna. Wave your hand. One. You pointing on her? She do have a hand? Where your hand, my dear? She have so much style. You see how she waving me? I never see that one yet. That's Patna wave. Would somebody say amen? Put your hands together for her, ladies and gentlemen. We have one from Patna. Now, Patna people, we can do better than that. Would somebody say amen? Patna people, we want you to bring at least 10 visitors tomorrow night. Amen? Amen? Let me see all our visitors from Dago Martin. Visitors from Dago Martin. We have one, two. Two? Put your hands together for them, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my. So Dago Martin beat Patna by one. Are we together? We're starting to count. Ushers, take that number for me, please. Head usher, where are you? Now, let me see how many visitors from Pity Valley. Just wave your hand. Wave your hand. Visitors from Pity Valley. That's not the same two visitors? Oh, Pity Valley. One, two, where? Three, four, five, six. One down there. Seven, eight. Amen. Where? Nine. Amen. Amen. 10. Amen. And then 11. And we have a little girl. 11 and a half. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Pity Valley. All right. So Pity Valley in the lead. But you know, Patna and Dago Martin, you could take over by tomorrow night. Are we together? And so we have a few visitors tonight. Any visitor coming for the first time? Hello? Praise. Now, you know, she take in front. Are we together? She take in front. She know how to repossess. Are we together? She had to bring two visitors tonight. You remember that, church? Ladies and gentlemen, so she know I was coming behind her, so she come first. Are we together? After she eat my pineapple, she didn't bring the visitor. But ladies and gentlemen, she brought something for me. Are we together? Should I keep it? No. You see, what she brought for me was not just a pineapple. She gave me double. Are we together? She made it, she pressed it down, she shake it together, and she make it run over, and she bring it for me. Put your hands together for her, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa, man. I like the vibe in here. Ladies and gentlemen, all crusades I give in, give. First time somebody give me a gift. Are we together? Amen. Put your hands together for her, ladies and gentlemen. You brought four, partner? All right. You want me to fix that? Let me see. Don't say partner one. You want me to fix that? Let me see the partner people. Just partner visitors, just raise your hand. One, two, three. Oh, okay. All right. So four. Put your hands together for him, ladies and gentlemen. They still have about seven. They have 11. Are we together? You have four. So you're seven behind. So you have to overtake them tomorrow night. Are we together? You go in for them. Amen. In Jesus' name. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this gift. What's some? I see mangoes. Are we together? I see champagne, starch mango. Would somebody say amen here tonight? Now. The pawpaw? Nah. That's a high-priced thing. So, ladies and gentlemen, high-priced items. And champagne, if you please. Non-alcoholic? Ladies and gentlemen, I want somebody to bring five visitors tomorrow night. And you come in to promise that you're going to bring five visitors tomorrow night. Are we together? Can you do that? Who's going to do that? And I'm giving you this whole gift. You giving that? You're going to bring five? Now, if you don't bring five, you have to bring a bigger gift than that for me. You know? You sure you're bringing five? You believe him, ladies and gentlemen? I think I should separate that gift for you. Huh? I'll give you the champagne. Come. Same five visitors, eh? Amen. Put your hands together for him, ladies and gentlemen. We're just sharing. It's our way of sharing. God bless you. God bless you. He has been here almost every night. Put your hands together for him, ladies and gentlemen. And we have some fruit. Somebody wants to bring five visitors. Somebody else want to take up the challenge? Just give me a wave. Huh? Somebody want to give me a... Are you coming, Brother Dale? You bringing them? Oh, no. He was just going to his post of duty. Somebody else? Somebody wants to say you want to bring three tomorrow night. You want to try? Oh, put your hands together for her, ladies and gentlemen. That's my good friend here. Come in advance. You want to try? Lord have mercy. Yes, you're going to try. So if you are bringing, you know I'll repossess. So you got to take in front. You must take the cue from that sister. Amen? Ladies and gentlemen, we are having a grand time. This is our fellowship time. Amen? It's always good when you come, we could fellowship, we could talk together, I could get to know you. But it's great to see that, you know, the I'm not seeing the Steele family so much anymore. You know who the Steele family is? The Seats. Brother and Sister Steele and all their children. So we don't want to see any steel tomorrow night. Are we together? We just want to see people in Jesus' name. Would somebody say amen? Ladies and gentlemen, we thank God that the weather changed today. Every day was rain. Lord have mercy. But you know what happened last night? Yesterday I was leaving Maracas, St. Joseph from USC. That's where I live, in that area. That's where I serve. And I was coming, and listen, it was pouring rain. The streets, the gutters, the drains were overflowing. And I'm coming down. When I hit the highway, I'm seeing dark clouds all the way. And I'm seeing a bright light at the end. I say, Lord, that has to be over Pity Valley. Would somebody say amen? As I drove coming down, and I hit Cocorite, and I looked down into the valley. Hello, somebody. I realized that the only place that I could see on Trinidad and Tobago. Hello, somebody. I didn't see Tobago, but I expect. On Trinidad and Tobago, that there was a blue sky yesterday. In the evening, was over Partner, Dago Martin, and Pity Valley. Put your hands together for Jesus, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I was praying for better weather, and the Lord told me, listen, the Lord was just encouraging my heart. He told me, I want you to see something. Would somebody say amen? I want you to see what I can do. Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't matter what weather it is. We have an appointment with God right here. I encourage you to come. I encourage all our visiting friends to come. Would somebody say amen? Ladies and gentlemen, we go into our topic right now. Remember our topic for tonight? Lord have mercy. Lord, it's on the screen. Shall we pray? Father, as we get into this hot topic, we pray for your peace. We pray for your blessings. We pray for your joy. And we pray for understanding. In Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, the subject of love has many people basodi. Are we together? Ladies and gentlemen, we love love. You could find the strongest, biggest, toughest man. Are we together? And the person who would soften his heart. Hello, somebody. It might be that special woman. Isn't that so? You could find the woman who is the most tough and abrasive, but there is a man. Hello, somebody. Who can make her feel happy. There was this woman who was married, but her husband passed. And she declared she will never, ever, ever love again. Ladies and gentlemen, she wasn't looking at a man twice. Men would be interested in her, and she wouldn't give them the second look. Are you listening to me out there? But one day she was in the grocery store and she wanted something at the top of the shelf. And when she thought she had everything covered and she was just trying to tiptoe to get it herself because she doesn't need a man, a tall, dark gentleman, hello somebody, shadowed over her, hello somebody, and said, "Can I help you?" Ladies and gentlemen, she felt that in the bottom of her heart. When she turned, it wasn't only a debonair voice, but it was a hunk of a man. She looked at him from head to toe and she started biting her lips. Are we together? Ladies and gentlemen, do you know that there is something called the body language of attraction? Ladies and gentlemen, when you are attracted to somebody, your body tells on you. You could try to hide it, but if that person knows human behavior, that person would know that you love them. Are we together? Don't mind them that sometimes they're passing you straight. Are we together? Like you don't exist. Sometimes it's because they have a crush on you. Are we together? They're passing you like they don't, and they want some attention. Are we together? Sometimes a woman will treat you bad because she wants you to give her more attention. You see she's saying yes? You see that? Ladies and gentlemen, the women that the social scientists say when they are attracted to you, they will expose their neck. Are we together? And they say it's a second nature thing. It has not been scientifically proven that human beings emits what they call pheromones. Are we together? But you know the entire perfume industry is based upon that. They give the man what is called something that's musk. Are we together? They say it's the pheromones that will attract women. And so women do this. Are we together? Have you seen a woman do that when you pass by? Are we together? They expose their neck and they touch in the... Are we together? Have you seen a woman do that, my elder? Yes, yes. They say that's the body language of attraction. Are we together? They say the woman will blush. Because what happens is that, and if the woman is fair skin, you would see it better. Ladies and gentlemen, what happens when a woman blushes is simply this, that the heartbeat is the heart is racing, it's pounding faster. Are we together? And it's sending blood at a faster rate. And when it hits the face, hello somebody, the face becomes red. Ladies and gentlemen, all that is the body language of attraction. women will blush, they would smile, they would giggle, and they would have they would express what you call nervous reactions in your presence. Biting of the lips. Are we together? I remember when I was dating my wife. She wasn't my wife yet, she was my girlfriend. Are we together? Now Brother Henry is her father, and he didn't know I was trying a thing. Brother Henry, you there? And we were in the library, are we together? And I was talking to her, and I was chatting, and listen, I'm talking to her, and I'm dropping some real heavy lyrics. Are we together? I'm supposed to be studying, but I'm chatting in Jesus' name. In the library. And she was sucking a mint. Are we together? And then I knew when I started getting through, because she stopped sucking the mint and she started chewing it. I heard mint breaking it up. I said, yes! Her face is the same. Are we together? She's masking the feelings, but she started chewing. I say, okay, first time I heard that, I'm getting through. Would somebody say amen? Oh, ladies and gentlemen, there is something beautiful about attraction. So this movie called Basil D is about that. Are we together? Ladies and gentlemen, I didn't finish the story of that woman that says she will never love again. So when she saw that man, the man got that item from the grocery shelf, and he asked her for a number, and she couldn't resist, and she started telling the number, you know, rubbing her, you know. When she realized she don't remember the number, she said, give me your phone. And she typed the number into his phone. He called her and they organized a date. Hello, somebody. Ladies and gentlemen, on that date, you know, she was only wearing black and white. But that day she was looking in her wardrobe and she pulled out the little red dress. Hello, somebody. Somebody bawling AA. Hello, somebody. The little red dress. And she put on that dress and she went out. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to let you know that we are created for love. God made us that way. Isn't that so? We love attention. We get attracted to the opposite sex naturally. Isn't that so? And so this woman, that movie is a Trinidadian movie. Isn't that so? And this woman whose father was almost getting a deal on an arranged marriage because she had a rich suitor and he was in debt. And he was getting through, actually, so that she can marry this man. But when she came to Trinidad, she saw a Rasta. Hello, somebody. Who was playing at the engagement party. Now, I haven't seen the movie, but I read the reviews. Hello, somebody. And she fell head over heels over this man. And ladies and gentlemen, no reason would prevail. She loved the music. She loved the man. She loved the vibes. And they described her as being Basil D. Ladies and gentlemen, the word of God says that Solomon is Basil D over love. Are we together? The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 30, verse what? 19 and 18 and 19. Everybody read it with me. He says what? There are what? There are three things that are what? Too amazing for me. Four things I do not understand. That is coming from the wisest man who ever lived. He says, one, the way of an eagle in the sky. He says, that's amazing. No effort, but he soars so high. The way of a snake on the rock. The way of a ship on the high seas. That big heavy vessel floating on the high seas. And a little rudder directing it. But the final thing he says that is too wonderful for me is the way of a man with his what? Middle. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Solomon said, listen, when he looks at the way men are with women, this thing is wonderful, too wonderful for him to understand. Ladies and gentlemen, people are searching for love every day. The greatest search on Google is about love. People want to know if they have true love. They want to know the signs of true love. They want to know what is true love. And one person I told you described love as the heterogeneous conglomeration of absurdity, calculated to bamboozle the anatomy of the one who is intoxicated by its irresistible, indomitable power. And that's love. That's what they say it's love is. Ladies and gentlemen, even after being in love, women want to know what do men want. And men want to know what do women want. So even after you think you have found that true love, you are still bamboozled, are we together, as to what this woman wants. Hello, somebody. Somebody say women change like the weather. Are we together? The women saying yeah, but the men sitting by the women, they're trying to stay still and they don't want to do nothing because they don't want some of them big and strong, but they're afraid. Are we together? They're holding their mouth. Look at them. But ladies and gentlemen, that's the beauty of the woman. Are we together? Women tell them you're just unpredictable. Are we together? You're just bringing life into their experience. But ladies and gentlemen, women want to know as well, what do men want? Ladies and gentlemen, our understanding, our studies say that, ladies and gentlemen, there are some things about love that's as fun as a carnival. What? A man is stimulated by what he sees. Am I speaking the truth, ladies and gentlemen? Am I speaking the truth? Ladies, so the man wants to see you looking good. Would somebody say amen? There are some women who are looking real good before they married. Are we together? You know how to dress. You know how to put it on and fix the hair. And after you get married, hello somebody, you think you have the man, so you just drop in yourself. Am I speaking the truth, ladies and gentlemen? You see, you were not his and you were taking care of. Now you are his, you need to take care of yourself. Are we together, ladies and gentlemen? When the man comes home, he doesn't want to see you with a mask. Are we together? Ladies, you there? Your head tied. You have a mask on your face. Are we together? You're dressing all, you have so much clothes on you. Hello, somebody. When the man comes home, he wants to see your hair. Well, are we together? I mean, not for church alone and work alone. Who you dressing for? You have to dress for the man. Would somebody say amen? You have to dress for him. Your hair has to be well combed. Would somebody say amen? You have to dress nice. Amen. You don't dress vulgar in the streets, but you must dress. Hello, somebody. Somebody say amen. 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 You need to fix it up. Would somebody say amen? You need to go to Victoria's Secret. Hello, somebody. Because at home you could wear it. It's not Victoria public knowledge. It's Victoria's Secret. Would somebody say amen? Don't wear it in the streets. But at home you must wear it. Would somebody say amen? Ladies, sometimes you're dressing too boring. Are we together? You need to bring some excitement into the house in Jesus' name. Hello, somebody. You must dress nice, and if he plays, you don't have his attention. Are we together? Just start exercising. Are we together? Hello, somebody. If he vexed with you, you just start exercising. Would somebody say amen? He making up one time in Jesus' name. Are we together? Oh, yes, I should preach on that every night. This is lover's night. Are we together? A man is attracted by what he sees. There's some women who always at home, or you, when you go to work, you're apart from your husband. Are we together? And your husband is at work and he's seen all those professional women. Are we together? In their high heels. Are we together? And the nursing uniform or the executive uniform. Are we together? You may not be a nurse or executive, but when he comes home, you need to be a nurse. Would somebody say amen? Hello, somebody. Put on some heels. and walk from the living room to the kitchen. Are we together? And say, can I help you? Because a man is stimulated by what he sees. Would somebody say amen? You gotta entertain him. Somebody say entertain. Entertain. Women say that word, entertain. Amen, amen. A woman vexed with me tonight. I see it. I'm not gonna look at her again. Entertain. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, but a woman is stimulated by what she... Hello, somebody. So a man will just look and he's excited. But a woman, are we together? You need to start working with her long before you come home in the evening. Are we together? Are we together? Whole day you at work, you ignore her. You even call her at lunchtime and say, honey, how was your day? Are we together? She wants to feel love. Not only just physical feeling, you know. She wants the affection. And so what happens? A woman may not give you the attention if you don't give her the affection. That's why the Bible says, husbands, love your wives, before the Bible says, wives, submit to your husbands. Because many times we think it's only when we're ready, are we together? When our eyes see, we want to treat her nice. Are we together? She know that that is hypocrisy. I remember one day, it was Valentine's Day, I was in St. Lucia. I went to the flower shop very early in the morning. Would somebody say amen? Got my flowers so that I could deliver it at work personally for her in Jesus' name. And when I come out of the flower shop, a Rasta man watched me and say, watch you in the system. Look at you. There, Valentine's Day. He said to me, Happy Hypocrite's Day. It's only on Valentine's Day you get in flowers. Only on Valentine's Day you buying chocolates. The man tell me that's Hypocrite's Day. Well, he rebuked me in Jesus' name. Are we together? 3 months later, I had to buy flowers again. Would somebody say amen? Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, because a woman wants to feel loved. Amen. So the man must work at it. It's mango season. You must bring mangoes home. Would somebody say amen? Somebody say amen. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, you must take care of the woman. She is stimulated by what she feels. You need to create the environment of love. You need to say those beautiful nothings in her ear. Are we together? Hold her hands. Massage her feet. Hello, somebody. Cut her toenails. Are we together? You may not be able to do it, but give the pedicure. Would somebody say amen? You need to treat her good. Amen? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. A woman is stimulated by what she feels. Ladies and gentlemen, there are 3 ways to express love. Casual, like holding hands. Intimate, like hugging and kissing. And ultimate, hello somebody, sexual expression. The thing about a woman is that most times, most women, because you have different types of women. You have women who are, you know, hot enough. Are we together? You have women who are frigid, cold. They never want it. Are we together? One day she have bellyache. One day she have headache. Are we together? The next day is always an ache. Are we together? So you were getting it at all. Frigid. Shop clothes, no business. Frigid. If you have that woman, quapo, smoke your pipe. Are we together? You got to warm her up in Jesus' name. Take her to a therapist. But ladies and gentlemen, there are some women who are hot. Like Potiphar's wife, pot of fire, piping hot. Ladies and gentlemen, there are some women who want it for breakfast, lunch, dinner. And when you come, they will tire you out. Are we together? You will go to work and you'll be sleeping on you. Ladies and gentlemen, but most women are happy with just the casual. Are we together? They just want you to embrace them, to hold their hands and walk down the road. They want to cuddle every night. But when you, and there are some women who could just go from casual to intimate. Isn't that so? Just want to kiss and make love. And then sometimes the ultimate. But most men, are we together? Once you hold their hands, are we together? That's first gear, they clutch in. Second gear, are we together? They even, it's automatic. Are we together? Once you hold hands, they feel you want it. Once you watch them wrong, are we together? Ladies and gentlemen, there are some men who move from casual, are we together, to intimate, to ultimate. But men, it's not every time a woman hugs and kiss, it must end up in sexual intercourse. Would somebody say amen? Sometimes they just want to cuddle. Are we together? Rainy days, dark nights, are we together? They just want to cuddle. It's not every time it rains. Are we together? Hello, hello, gentlemen. Come on, come on, come on. The men vexed with this, you know. But you must have balance. Amen. Give us some time to recover in Jesus' name. So most times when women think about relationships and love, she is yearning for affection from that gentleman. But the man, when he looks at the woman, he's thinking what? We are from two different worlds. Are we together? She just wants affection when she looks into his eyes. And when he looks into her eyes, he's thinking, hello, somebody. And so, ladies and gentlemen, there is a lot of, that's just one aspect of the conflict that happens in relationships because we have a different agenda. Isn't that so, ladies and gentlemen? Ladies and gentlemen, a man is aroused. Are we together? When a man see you, he is aroused. Are we together? If he's a healthy man, he will wake up. Hello, somebody. A man is aroused, but a woman decides to be what? The woman has to go through her mind first and decide. Are we together? This is good. I will. Oh, hello, somebody. So gentlemen, sometimes the gentlemen just want to start and they just want to go to the ultimate just one time. It doesn't work like that, gentlemen. Are we together? You need to do some hugging. Would somebody say amen? You need to do some holding hands. You need to do some kissing. You know how many people I have counseled before marriage and you think that they will go through the motions and a woman calls me a few months after. She's saying, Pastor, teach him about preparation. Even God has a preparation day. Would somebody say amen? The man just wants to go like she's a machine. There's one who told me, Pastor, I don't know, I can't deal with that. I'm not a robot. You need to prepare the woman. Would somebody say amen? And preparing is not only physical. Are we together? Some men want the women to go to work, come back and do all the work in the house. Are we together? And then you want her to have energy for you. You need to wash the dishes sometimes. Would somebody say amen? Sometimes all the loving the woman need is you cleaning the house. Would somebody say amen? And making the bed in Jesus' name. Am I speaking to men tonight? The men were happy at the being you sad now. You need to clean up and help the woman around the house. Give her a day off from housework. Would somebody say amen? How many women want a day off from housework tomorrow? On Sunday. Are we together? You want a day off? Amen. Amen. Tell him you want a day off. Are we together? By the way, I'll give you a voucher. Are we together? When you come tomorrow night, one day off. On that day, you just give him the voucher. And he has to prepare breakfast. Would somebody say amen? He has to wash the clothes, wash the dishes in Jesus' name. Women, you want that voucher? Put your hands. Don't put your hands up. Ladies and gentlemen, sometimes the man needs to give gifts and the woman also could give gifts just because. Take her out to dinner. It's not only before you commit. You must be romantic. After you have her, you must also be romantic as well. Would somebody say amen? Oh yes, oh yes. Ladies and gentlemen, the woman wants affection. The Bible tells us about affection in the book of Songs of Solomon. Would somebody say amen? Are you ready for this one? The Bible talks about affection. Now, Songs of Solomon is biblical. What somebody say? It's in the Bible. Can I preach on it tonight? Amen. Amen. Some of you so holy, you can't even read a little Songs of Solomon. Are we together? Some of you so holy, you can't even, you have to break. Are we together? Out of it and be romantic sometimes, gentlemen. You need to be romantic, ladies. Amen? That's holiness in Jesus' name. So here's Solomon now. Chapter 4, verse 1, it says, "Behold, thou art fair, my love. Behold, thou art fair. Thou hast dove's eyes." Hello, somebody. Have you ever seen a nice white dove? He's saying, listen, the white of your eyes. Hello, somebody. Is as bright as a beautiful dove. Thou hast dove's eyes. "And the locks within thy locks, thy hair is as a flock of goats, appearing from Mount Gilead." Hello, somebody. That's Shaq. Hello, somebody. Now, if a man tells you your hair is like a flock of goats, you will be insulted right now. But back then, it was a compliment. You know why? There was no flat screen TV. Are we together? There was nothing to look at. And you know what Solomon looked at? He was looking at the mountains. Are we together? And when you see a set of black goats run from one side of the mountain to the other, it's like the woman, you know? Would somebody say amen? The man, use your imagination. That's the flat screen TV. He said, listen, your hair, when you move, it's like a flock of goats. You can appreciate it now? Amen. "Thy teeth," would somebody say amen? So he starts from the top, isn't that so? Then he goes where? To thy? So he's looking at her face. He's looking at her eyeball to eyeball, you know. You know, women, you like the men to look at you in your eyes? You know, the women, you know, put down their... When you look at them in their eyes, they get nervous and they get excited. "Thy teeth are like a flock of sheep that are even shorn." Are we together? In other words, her teeth white. Are we together? "And they even, one not longer than the other, which have just come up from the washing." Her mouth is clean. Would somebody say amen? She said, "You, your teeth are like you just finished brush your teeth. It looks bright and neat." Would somebody say amen? "Whereof every one of them bear twins, and there is none barren among them." All her teeth in her mouth. Would somebody say amen? That's chat. You have all your teeth. And they're looking good. "Thy lips," hello somebody. The women getting excited here. "Thy lips are like a thread of scarlet." Are we together? They're bright. "Thy speech is not only what your lips looking good, but what comes out of your mouth." Are we together? When you talk, you sound good and you say good things. Would somebody say amen? "Thy temples are like pieces of pomegranates within thy locks." Are we together? He says, listen, you are looking good. "Thy neck," would somebody say amen? So he starts from here. Are we together? He reached teeth. He reached where? The man is going down. Would somebody say amen? Pray for me, church. "Thy neck are like the Tower of David, builded as an armory." She stands proud. Her head is not down. "Whereon are hung 1,000 butlers, all shielded with mighty armor." Ladies and gentlemen, she walks stately. Isn't that so? "Thy two breasts." Would somebody say amen? "Are like two young roes that are twins." You know what a young roe is? A young roe. Listen, all right. When a young roe stands up, it stands up tall and straight. Would somebody say amen? Somebody born no gravity. Lord have mercy. I didn't say it. "That are twins which feed among the lilies." Thy lips. He go back to lips. Lord have mercy. I wonder if that's code language. Because he's going down. Hello, somebody. I say no more. Thy lips, oh my spouse. He's getting excited. Hello, somebody. He has arrived. You know, when you're preparing a woman, are we together? They say you have to take her to the gates of heaven and stop. Are we together? And you have to wait for her to let you in. You don't barge in. Would somebody say amen? You have to get her so excited that she begs you. Some people holding themselves tight like that. Tight, tight. Thy lips, O my spouse, drop as the honeycomb. Honey and milk are under her tongue. Lord have mercy. And the smell of thy garments are like the smell of Lebanon. Hello, somebody. A garden what? Enclosed in my is my sister, my spouse. A spring shut up, a fountain sealed. Ladies and gentlemen, she seems to be a virgin. Lord have mercy. You don't understand it yet. One of these days. Awake, O north wind, and come thou south, and blow upon my garden. She says that thy spices, that the spices may flow out. Let my beloved come into his garden and eat of his pleasant fruits. Would somebody say amen? Let the church say amen. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible is pregnant with instruction. Would somebody say amen? Trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Would somebody say amen? Ladies and gentlemen, you know what the Bible says. Women, don't defraud your husband. Are we together? Husband, don't defraud your wife. Let me tell you something. When you are married, you must have plenty. Would somebody say amen? If you are married, you must have any. You mustn't have any. But when you're married, would somebody say amen? You must have plenty. The Bible says, render unto your wife. Men, render it. Would somebody say amen? The Bible says, render due benevolence unto your husbands. Wives, render it. I remember while I was working in Canada, I preached at a church and me and a group of students, we went to this guy's home. Now he seems to be almost a millionaire, rich man. We went to that brother's home. Are we together? And we went for lunch and boy, the table was spread. And then he told me, man, come downstairs. So he brought me downstairs and I saw his basement. Ladies and gentlemen, he had all types of games down there. He had a pool table. He had a pinball table. He had a table. He said, listen, that's the domino table. Many men get damaged right there. Are we together? Ladies and gentlemen, this man had everything at his home. He said, let me tell you something. I don't go anywhere to get entertained. I get all the entertainment here. And this man was just a happy man, contented man. So when we were about to eat lunch, one of the students said, ask him, listen, sir, why are you so happy? Why are you so happy? He said, ask my wife. So she went and asked the wife, why is your husband so happy? The wife said, because I feed him. He's nodding his head. Say, is food you like so much? He said, not food. When she looked at the wife said, yeah, I feed him. I feed him in the morning. Hello, somebody. I feed him. I just keep the plate full. Would somebody say amen? I feed him in Jesus' name. Wives, feed your husbands. Would somebody say amen? Don't let them go starving. Make sure their belly full. Husbands, feed your wives. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I think you understand. Ladies and gentlemen, you see, love is absorbed with the good of the other person. Love is not self-centered. Would somebody say amen? Love is other-centered. Anytime a man tell you he loves you, but then his conversation is, I want this and I want that. I don't like you to, I. That's not true love. Because love is concerned about your good. Would somebody say amen? And so love is concerned about doing things for the good of your wife or your husband. Anytime a woman says she loves you, but it's only I want and I'm not happy and I, that's not love. Love asks about you. How was your day? How do you feel about this? I'm sorry for treating you like that. How can I do better? Hello, somebody. And if you take care of your spouse and your spouse takes care of you, both of you would be happy. Would somebody say amen? So we need to be taking care of each other. The Bible declares love is what? Patient. So husbands and wives must be patient with each other. Sometimes you're married and for years there is something that's not going right, but you need to be patient. You want to see a certain change, husband or wife, and the person tries and the change is not coming very quickly, there needs to be patience on your part. Would somebody say amen? The Bible says love is patient and is kind. Therefore, you suffering long, you patient, you suffering long, but your face not long. Are we together? It's not good. It's not the way you want it, but you must smile. Would somebody say amen? And you must make the person feel happy, even if the person is not living up to your expectations, because love is patient and kind at the same time. You may be angry, but you must be kind. You must speak kind words. You may be disappointed, but you must be kind. You may be brokenhearted, but love is kind and is patient. Love is not kind sometimes. Love is always patient and is always kind. Would somebody say amen? Love does not envy. Does not boast. Some people, they're jealous of their spouse, you know. They don't want their spouse to go by their mother or by their father. Hello, somebody. Love does not boast, doesn't put up itself, is not proud, is not rude. Is there a right reason to behave bad? Is there a right reason to misbehave? Love is not rude. We must be gentle. Would somebody say amen? All the criticism and critical words in the home must turn into compliments, because we should not be rude to each other. I read a passage in Steps to Christ that talks about Jesus. The Bible says he was never rude. He never spoke a discomforting word. But every time he spoke a word of rebuke, it was with tears in his voice. If we're going to talk and rebuke and say, listen, I'm angry, and rebuke your spouse, it mustn't be done as if you are perfect and you're looking down on the person. It must be done with love and tears in your voice. It must be done in a humble manner. Love is not proud. It's not self-seeking, not easily angered. There are some people all the time, they at home, they vex. Are we together? When they come to church, they're smiling and they're saying, happy Sabbath. They're nice with everybody at work. And once they reach by the home, the cat running, the dog running, the children running, the wife running. Love is not easily angered. It keeps no record of what? Come on, you're not with me. Keeps no record of what? Ladies and gentlemen, when something happens today and then you have to bring up something in 1982 and 1995 and 2003 and 2010 and look, you do it again, ladies and gentlemen, it is not fair. It's not right. Sometimes you bury your partner and you depress your partner. Love doesn't keep record of wrong. You deal with it and you drop it. Would somebody say amen? It rejoices. It does not rejoice in evil, but rejoices in the truth. Always protects. Would somebody say amen? Always trusts. Always hopes. Always perseveres. Love never fails. There is somebody in a relationship who is about to give up, but love does not fail. God can fix it for you. Would somebody say amen? Love is a principle. While they were nailing Jesus on the cross, he was saying, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He was willing to save them. That's why the greatest text in the Bible is what? For what? God, the greatest lover. Would somebody say amen? So love, the greatest extent. So is an adverb of extent. So love the world. That's the greatest extent. The world, the greatest number. That he gave, the greatest act. His only son, the greatest gift. Prince of heaven, the greatest gift. That whosoever, the greatest invitation. It doesn't matter who you are, what you've done, what people think about you, what you think about yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, the invitation is yours. Whosoever believeth in him, he has that invitation for you. He loves you. Should believeth the greatest simplicity. Would somebody say amen? Whosoever believeth, anybody who believes, it's so simple. You just believe that Jesus Christ has died for your sins, that he took your penalty on Calvary's cross. What was on the cross? Your sins were nailed to the cross. He paid your price. Your sin went to the cross. And his righteousness covers you. You just need to believe that he paid the price for all your sins. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, believe that he paid the price. The greatest simplicity. In him, the greatest person. Whosoever believeth in him should not the greatest deliverance. Would somebody say amen? Should not perish, but the greatest exception. Have the greatest assurance. Everlasting life, the greatest possession. Would somebody say amen? Oh, ladies and gentlemen, he loves you with an everlasting love. He died that your sins might be forgiven. He died so that you would have a better life. He died, the Bible says, but God commandeth his love towards us, that while we were what? Yet sinners, Christ died for us. You were still a sinner. You were still messed up. And he died for you because he's dreaming about you. He has a plan for you. Ladies and gentlemen, he loves you with an everlasting love. And one of these days, he's coming back again. Would somebody say amen? He's coming for people who love him. You didn't hear me here tonight. He's coming for people who love him. Love requires action. And if you love God, the Bible says, if you love him, what? Keep my commandments. He has demonstrated his love. He did it on the cross. Love demands a sacrifice. He did it on the cross just for you and just for me. And he says, if you love me, obey me. Hello, somebody. Keep my commandments. Jesus said that. He left heaven and he came to earth to say that. Who are we to say that the commandments are abolished? Oh, love leads to obedience. The Bible says, whosoever committeth sin also committeth lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. Last night we said sin is transgression of the law. Love meets the requirement of the law. Would somebody say amen? Love says the law has no problems. Sin is breaking the law. The Bible says whosoever, therefore, love is the what? Love is the what? Love is the fulfillment of the law. We are not under the law until we break the law. Then we are under the condemnation of the law. But grace, would somebody say amen, gives us overcoming power over that broken law. And so we live in grace. What is the role of the law? The law is there to show me my sins so that I can confess and have salvation. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to end on this. The law shows you who you really are. It cannot fix you. It's the love of Jesus that will fix you. And if you love Jesus, you will obey him. The law points out your defects. The law cannot clean you. But by the law, you have knowledge of your sin. I would not know sin except by the law. But I am saved by grace through faith. Ladies and gentlemen, God calls us to obey. Would somebody say amen? Amen. Adam and Eve lost because of disobedience. But they found Jesus because of his grace. Would somebody say amen? Tonight, I want to make an appeal. Tonight, God's people need to make a decision to obey him. Tonight, God is calling for demonstration of obedience, of love.
He's calling.
And that's obedience. If you want to demonstrate to Jesus, and you want to say, Jesus, I love you. I want to live for you.
Tell
just
me
raise your hand to heaven. Oh, yes, you're serious about this love. And you want to walk in that love. Stand to your feet, wherever you are. Stand to your feet.
For a life friend.
Tonight, I'm calling first the visitors. I want to pray for you tonight that the Lord will give you overcoming power. Ladies and gentlemen,
there's a voice deep inside.
The Bible tells us if we love the Lord, we must be his
servant,
including the Seventh-day Sabbath.
Say,
we have a Sabbath celebration coming. This
me.
Coming Sabbath.
Even
God is calling people to obey him.
Still
you want to walk in obedience. Leave wherever you are. Come. God bless you as you come, my friend.
Going on,
come, my friend. You want to walk in obedience, you come. Come, you want to walk in obedience,
somehow
you come. Visitors everywhere, you have heard the voice of God. Many people who are standing here, they are living in obedience. But you want to make a decision to walk in obedience. You leave wherever you are and you come. God bless you. You want to express your love to Jesus. You want to live a life of obedience. You come. God bless you as you come. Your time has come. Come, come tonight. For a life brand new. Oh, God's people are coming. Every visitor needs to be at the altar. You heard the word of God and you understood it. Leave wherever you are. Join me at the altar. Jesus is calling tonight. He's calling you. Come. Come tonight.
You remember when you said before that you needed something more. Now it's time to realize he's knocking at your door. Things that you used to do
no longer appeals to you. Come.
Somehow don't appeals
to you. Why will you deny that you don't want them anymore?
Listen to Jesus tonight.
Listen, child.
Come all the way.
And don't be afraid anymore. Calling you.
Come, my friend.
Calling you. Tell me, what are you going to do? Your time has come for a life brand new. Oh,
bless you, my friend. Somebody else wants to give Jesus their heart tonight.
He is calling you. Tell me what, God bless you, my friend, to do. Your time has come for a life,
a brand new life, my friend. Don't delay. Would you come to the altar? A blessing awaits you. The power of God in your life awaits you. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, peace and joy. Say yes.
Say yes. Please say yes. Oh, yes. Say yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
He's calling you today. Come, my friend. Oh, every visitor at the altar. My brother says, God invites you to make a decision on what you have heard. You believe you have heard the truth, you come. Tonight, I would like the Bible workers to just give out. I have a survey card for you. A survey card for all my visitors at the altar. Come. Distribute it to them, each one of them. I would like to know where you are in your decision for Jesus. Just give me one, please. Thanks. Yes. Since I love Jesus, I desire to obey him. If you love Jesus and you desire to obey him, tick that box. Is it clear to you that the true Bible Sabbath is Saturday? I'm preaching a very important message. Come tomorrow night. You can't afford to miss it. If you believe that, tick yes. I love Jesus and choose to follow him by keeping the Sabbath holy. I want to survey you tonight. And I also want to survey you tomorrow night after the message. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very important survey for my friends. My friend here, please give him a card. Every visiting friend must get a card tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we are having Sabbath celebration. Right under this tent, Sabbath morning coming. There is no excuse for not being here on Sabbath, because God requires you to keep the Sabbath holy. We're going to have a dynamic time this Sabbath coming, and God is calling you to be here. I also want to challenge you. Do not miss the message tomorrow night. Hello, somebody. And you cannot miss the message on Friday night. These are important messages. Ladies and gentlemen, you cannot miss the experience on Sabbath morning. Sabbath morning, we're dealing with the topic, a sign in the human heart. A sign in the human heart. We're going to look and see that there is something that God is calling you to do. But we're also going to see that sign in the human heart that tells us that Jesus is about to come and we need to make our decision now. Are you listening to me out there? Sign in the human heart. You can't afford to miss this coming Sabbath. I want to make an appeal for our membership for prayer. You desire to support these persons who have come out in obedience, but you also want to live a life of obedience. Just leave wherever you are as you come. Come to the altar for prayer.
When you walk with the Lord, in the light of his word, what a glory he sheds on our way. While we do his,
everybody, he abides with us.
He abides with us still.
Give me that bass there.
And to all who will trust and obey. And obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Shall we pray as we close? Loving Lord, we thank you for the power and the wonder and the majesty of your presence. We thank you, O Father, for what you are doing in our hearts as we come here nightly. O Father, we pray that you will multiply and magnify this effect of conversion. O Father, we pray for Pity Valley that you will turn hearts to you. We pray for Partner that you will turn hearts to you. We pray for Dago Martin that you will turn hearts to you. We pray for the churches who are seated as lighthouses in these communities. May your people commit to the salvation of souls in their community. We pray, oh God, tomorrow night that the churches will come out and the members will come out with a friend. Yeah, with two friends, with three friends. Oh Father, when they come out, oh God, we pray for 20 visitors from Partner and 20 visitors from Dago Martin and 50 visitors from Pity Valley. Oh God, we pray that you would shake this community for you. Oh God, it's not too late to shake it. Oh God, because you shook the world on that day of Pentecost and one message brought 3,000 people to the foot of the cross. Oh Father, we pray, oh God, that something will happen in this community. Oh, may we have the tenacity of the disciples so that we may work to see souls being converted to you and saved in your kingdom. We pray for those who came to the altar and who have signed those cards, bless them and seal that decision to obey you. We pray, oh God, come Sabbath morning, that many of them will make decisions to be baptized, oh Father, and go all the way with you. We pray, oh God, that that will be their decision in Jesus' name. Let God's people say. Ladies and gentlemen, may God richly bless you. May the peace of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you now and forevermore. May God richly bless you.